Hey guys, how's it going? Happy, let's be honest, it's still Monday, but I'm shooting a couple videos. So my last video was under 10 minutes. Thank you very much, high five me. Also, just got my nails done. Moving from red into beginning to get neutral, and then we go into French obnoxious manicure. As, who was that one guy? There used to be this guy, I think I finally blocked him. But he used to always come to my channel and say that I was a stripper because I had long nails. Always appreciated that. There's so many sweet people out in YouTube land. Anyway, so today, this is not even. This one's falling off, they're both gonna fall off. Today, I wanna tell you guys, I talked about in my last video, kind of focusing on some of the little changes that I'm making and then getting into more details instead of doing what I used to do, which is get into all the details about everything in one video, and that's how they ended up being 20 minutes. So in my last video, I talked about weighing food. In fact, I'm sitting here as we speak. Let me just show you the sushi place that I order from. How can you complain about sashimi that's that beautiful? Dip it in a little soy sauce. I don't eat a whole piece all at once, especially not when I'm shooting a video. Mmm. But of course I'm gonna drool all over myself, which is okay. I love sashimi. Anyway, very easy to hit my macros with that. Today's low carb day, so have to be a little bit more creative when I'm at 80 carbs a day versus 150 on my other day, so there you go. But I still get to have a Quest bar today, which I already had, with Jif whip topping on the top. Hello, just figured those out. Found those at Walmart. Anyway, today, what I want to tell you guys about is what I have added to my daily routine, which actually reminds me I'm going to need to do it right after this video, to deal with the back pain that I was gifted with last year that really sidelined me. Talk about all that in a different video. And my, I guess I can call it like running issue. I thought it was my ankles. I thought I had an Achilles problem, but it turns out that it was my calves. So two things that I now do and have added to everything that I do on a daily basis. The reason that I'm sharing this is a lot of you guys ask, what is it that you're doing? How are you dealing with back pain that you know, you're saying you really don't have the back pain anymore? Which, you guys, it was probably, the back pain started last summer. I'd have to look at dates, but I'm guessing it was like July or August is when it started. Because I remember it was the first time my man friend came to visit me. We were joking, like, you know, did you hit me with a baseball bat last night and I didn't notice it? Why do I have back pain all of a sudden? It was very sudden. And then I kept thinking, did I deadlift the wrong way? Whatever. But you guys, from that point, it just got progressively worse, even though I was cutting back on lifting, cutting back on doing a lot of weights because it was starting to hurt more and more. And, you know, then I started going to see a chiropractor and that helped, but it was just never really going away. I had gotten to the point where I'm like, now I so miss those days when I didn't have it. Because every time I got out of bed, I'd go to put my workout pants on and I'd be like this and I'd feel it in my lower back. I felt everything, every part of the day. And I'll do this when I do a separate video, but one of the things that was a life turner for me, or a game changer for me, was reading this book by John Sarno called Mind Over Back Pain. And I read the whole book in one night, and I remember I threw it down because I thought the premise of the book was kind of silly. But he's basically like, unless you're those people that need spinal fusion therapy or surgery, excuse me, or something really, really serious, most people can really change their back pain because so much of it is exacerbated, I hope I'm not saying the worst choice of words, by stress and by, you know, kind of our own mental baggage around it. So he was like, you know, a lot of us are in control of changing our back pain situation for the better. And I remember thinking, this is so dumb. I kept thinking there was going to be some secret move or secret pills I could take or secret surgery or something specific, but it wasn't. He was like, look, you know, you've got to start focusing on how you stand. You know, let me just tell you guys, you can see how I'm standing right now. Maybe you can't, but you see, like, this is good posture. This is not the best way for me to show you. Okay. Most of my life I have spent, I would be standing here like this would be how I would stand before. Now, I don't know if you can see this. There's a difference between this, and you might think, And this is why I think a lot of women don't do this. We don't stand up straight because we think we're sticking our boobs out, right? And if you look at how a dancer, somebody with really great posture stands, you know, that's the way you stand. But just because God gave you boobies doesn't mean that you should be like this. But a lot of women with a chest, that's what we do. And we stand over, and I have one leg that's shorter than the other, so I'm double jointed in those legs. So I was always like leaning back and standing over. And let me just tell you, you add up years of bad posture instead of standing. You know, I don't know, again, if you guys can tell. Here's poor posture, Kelly, slouching. Here's correct posture, and this is the way I sit now. I sit this way. I avoid sitting at all costs because, again, back to what he said in this book, he's like, most people don't get back pain from some specific injury. It's from, you know, and they show you what happens when you sit, how everything gets kind of squashed up, and it's horrible for you. And you might think, I like to sit down. It's awesome. Let me tell you. Right now, sitting is my enemy. I spend more time here when I do a call, I walk around my place. Sitting is the area where if I do it too much, especially at my office desk, that's where I start to feel it the most in my back. But he was like, you've got to have core strength, you've got to have the right kind of chairs, you've got to have the right kind of posture. And he was more about that it's psychosomatic, it's all about stress. And I was like, this is so dumb. Here's what I've done, you guys. I'm at 6 minutes, so I'm closing in on the end of my video, but I'm gonna do this. For my calves, okay, when I was diagnosed, it was not an Achilles issue that was keeping me from running. This was about a year ago. If I'm correct, was it last year at the Arnold? Maybe it was just a year ago. I'll have to look that up again. Anyway, Dr. Prisk was the one who looked at my ankles and bent them all over the place and my calves, and he's like, it's not your ankles, it's your calves. You never stretch them. They're so ridiculously tight, and therefore, they're causing, you know, this issue in this part of the outside of my ankle. So 3 times a day, I do one calf stretch for each leg. I'm about to sneeze. And I do them for 30 seconds each leg. Now, I count out myself, so I'm counting fast. But it's hard to explain. It's like a calf stretch where you just, you put one foot behind the other, you know, and you kind of lean into the wall. But instead of my foot being straight, I take that back foot and I twist it in that way. So it's really stretching that outer side of my calf more. 30 seconds each leg, switch, 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 5 times each leg. I do that 3 times a day. And I don't care if I'm in a movie theater, I'll get up and do my stretches. I do them 3 times a day because, you guys, I don't ever want to deal with that injury again, and I have learned. Secondly, so that's what I do for my calves. And then, now when I finish working out, I take the time to stretch. I didn't do that for years and years and years. Why? Kept saying I was too busy. I stretch. It feels great. It makes a difference, not only in just flexibility and because you feel cool, but it also has a huge impact on your body. And then lastly, what I do for my back, now whenever I do my calf stretches, I'm gonna do this right when I'm finished with you guys here in this video. I'm gonna do my calf stretches and then I go in whatever room and I do a plank hold. And what I did is I started off at 1 minute plank hold. Now I count myself. I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 2, 2, 3, 4. So I'm probably counting a little faster. The end of the day, what's important to me is that I'm increasing my time each day. So I started off at 1 minute. I'm up to 3.5, if I'm correct. I thought I was at 4, but I'm kind of at a little bit of a holding pattern where I get really shaky and my arms are that way. But I've increased and I do a plank hold 3 times a day. After that, I move into pretty much, it's a version of like cobra or up dog, if you're familiar with yoga. So I go plank position all the way down to the floor, and then I push back and I'm in my arched back cobra position. It's more like, yeah, cobra than up dog because I'm not pushing myself all the way up. Really arching my back and holding that for, again, as long as I hold my plank holds. 3 times a day, a simple addition to what I'm doing, you guys, made a huge difference. That's all I have to say. 9 minutes, under 10, yes!